Hello, welcome, or welcome back. Today I want to try something new, something fresh, something different. I want to speak into my microphone, give you the movement instruction, and then do the movements myself, and then come up again and give you the next instruction. And we will use a lesson, flexion, extension, cycle. Helps tremendously when you have like a head pecking forward, slouched shoulders, like when you're in this flexion pattern. Very beneficial to find your neutral, to be standing up easily, to this fear that clogs up here. Like if you know what is depression, you know, when you know what is fear, this tends to be stuck here, and we're gonna open it and we will feel more at ease. So what do you think? As always, please come to lie, as always, not always, but as so often, please come to lie onto your back. So for the first movement, you're on your back. And you can have your legs, have your feet standing, you're lying on your back, the feet standing, which means the knees are going to be pointed towards the ceiling. So usually in class, I can look at you, but I cannot look at you, so I have to look into my mind how you would look like. So you can have your legs extended or your feet standing. And then the first, this is the... starting position. So the first movement is just to lift your head, and you can do this just a very little bit, just a tiny little bit is enough, because we want to, as I explained in the principles of movement, we want to address the muscles on the front side, especially in the upper part of the rib cage, like all these muscles that are in between the ribs here next to your chest bone, and they should contract. So you don't have to lift your head much, just a tiny little bit, and you can use your hands to feel your chest, to feel these muscles contracting. They will contract if you lift the head. Yeah, so this is the movement. Let's do this first. Just a bit. And then... no, let's continue a little bit. And then let's do the other end. Stand both feet. So this is the starting position. Both feet are standing. The knees are pointing towards the ceiling. And you start to lift your feet a little bit, and by lifting the feet, your stomach belly muscles, abdominal muscles, will contract, because they need to stabilize your back. And when you bring your knees a little bit over your chest, the pelvis will roll backwards a little bit, and then you can do the very beginning of lifting your head. So these muscles again on the front of your chest start to contract. This is what I call signal highlighting. They start and there's this signal, and pattern harmonization when you lift your head and your knees, and you start to round up like a hedgehog who's on his back, but not that much, just a little bit, and then let go again. And yeah, you can work with your breathing to let go again. And let me participate. So that's a whole lot of movements, and then let's see. Okay, so please take a rest if you have not yet took a rest, taken, rested, paused, a little pause. So that was interesting, yes. So in the beginning, for me, it was too difficult to lift the head, but it kind of was so heavy, my head, so I had to use my arms to lift my head. And then to lift both feet at the same time also seemed to be very strenuous, like a big act. So I just lifted one foot first and then the other one. And then in the end, everything came together a bit better. So it was actually, I could lift my head without my hands, and I could focus more on this chest area. That was interesting. Okay, so this relaxes me so deeply. The next movement, let's do the other side, the extension pattern. So we flip over like a pancake. The next movement will start on the belly, and we will try to lift the head symmetrically in the center, like we try to lift the head symmetrically in the center when we do the previous flexion movement. To do that, the forehead needs to rest on both hands. So we start with this to lift the head, and with the eyes you look up a little bit and then down again, and you so it's first it's just a lifting of the head, and you feel how your back tries to lift the head, and you could push a little bit with your hands, but then we don't want to push with the hands. So either push or not push, but it should be the back extensor muscles that do the work, so it shouldn't be the arms. And then also we have legs in this position as well, so we could start to lift the legs. We could have the legs, the knees bent or straight. We can play with this. So to play into this centered extension movement. You know what I mean? Everything is the exercise clear? The task at hand. So please come to lie onto your belly and yeah, lift the head or lift the leg and see how lifting the head and lifting the leg works together. How you contract, how these contractions feels like, how you perceive it, how you can get better at it, more detailed, and then how you consciously release this extension again. This is contraction and release, but it's not an isometric like in autogenous training or in progressive relaxation, Jacobson, but it's like contracting into lifting the head, it's a function, or lifting the legs, extending the, what is it, psoas or whatever, lengthening the whole front side, contracting the whole back side, and then let go again. So let's do this. All right, then bring this to an end. If you haven't already, take a rest. That again was very interesting. For me, I discovered suddenly, so I started to lift with the head, and suddenly I noticed my pelvis, that I can enter this extension movement, this arching of the back, by just lifting the pelvis. So between my, how you call it, groin and the floor, there will be a space, and it's like lifting the pelvis off the floor, but the knees stay on the floor. So that was very interesting. And then when the pelvis was up already, so there was this arching in my back, I could add lifting the leg. And then what happened? And then I could lift the leg without lifting the pelvis first. It became easier. And then in the end, also the lifting of the head was easier. Interesting progression. I'm curious to read your discoveries. Okay, so pancake. Let's bake the other side one more time. And so the next movement will be on in supine position on your back, please. If you're not already on your back, so turn on your back and stand your feet. And again, lift your head. You can help with your hands. Yes, help with your head, hand to lift your hand. And we will explore a little bit side bending and rotation while flexion. So you can bring either, when you lift your head, your left elbow towards your right knee, or your right elbow towards your left knee, or the right elbow towards your right knee and the left the same side, or cross over, or bend a little bit to the side while lifting the head, and explore, or you could have your head turned to one side and explore this deviation from the midline and then coming back to the midline, in addition to the movement we did first. So our main focus, our main theme is still flexion, but you can add all these extra movements and see, and of course breathing and your eyes, eye work, and whatever you can come up with or think of. Yes, task is clear. So please come onto your, we start on the back to explore this movement. All right, so please bring this to an end if you have not yet started to take a rest or make a pause. Also, for me, very nice movements. I folded up more than usual, but I was not, I mean, I did this yesterday and the day before already. I'm doing this since 3 days now, and it's getting better every day, day by day. And right in the beginning, when I started to do this movement right now, I felt immediately the connection between my pelvis and my head is so much more there. Like when I move my pelvis a little bit, my head easier to lift, or when I lift the head, it's easier to tilt the pelvis backwards. It's very apparent, a very nice feeling. And yeah, so it brings me into a more, into a state where I'm quite satisfied with my movements. And then I explored reaching in between my legs instead of just bringing the elbow to the knee, because it brings me more into a rotation, but also involves more my pectoralis muscles, like this upper part of my shoulder just comes up a little bit better if I reach downwards more, and brings me more into a flexion, which then I can really, so I just discovered this right now again, of course. Okay, so the last part, flip over the pancake. We do the same thing on starting in a prone position on the belly. We're going back into extension, and also on the belly, we leave the midline. We play with bending a little bit to the left and to the right. We play with deviation from the midline, with turning the head, with rotation, and see how that helps or disturbs the extension pattern, right? So please, on your front side, let's do this kind of exploration. All right, so then please bring this to an end. And if you haven't already, do one more flexion movement. So come onto your back and curl up like in the beginning and see how it is now at the end of this lesson, of this exploration we did together to lift your head, how it is to lift your head in comparison to the beginning of our little session. Yes, and also now this was very interesting and very apparent. The moment I lifted my head on in prone on my belly, it pushed my feet downwards. So there was this strong connection, this very apparent connection between my head movements that translate all the way down to my feet. And it was just nice to feel how yes, I'm one person and how everything relates to each other again. Yeah, okay. So the last thing we need to try is how it is in standing. I leave this to you to come up and feel your neutral, how your head is balanced, how your pelvis is balanced, how your feet are balanced, how it is in standing. What do you feel? What do you perceive? Please, if you like this video, leave a like, leave a comment to share how it was for you. Share the video. Yeah, and tell me if you like this kind of format. It's the first time I just invented this. Yeah, and thank you for watching. See you in the next video. So if you're interested in how I do the recordings, I use my camera, which is a Sony Alpha 6400. I think it's great and it doesn't have any recording limit, which means I can record more than half an hour in one go. For this purpose, I also use a power bank connected directly to the camera so I don't run out of juice. I use the standard kit lens, which comes with the camera. It's an all-purpose lens and it's just really great. I love it. And for the video today I used DT Pro, one of the best consumer levels microphone at the moment. Never used it before, so we'll see how it turned out. I use a clamp here and an umbrella because I don't have a microphone stand, and I record into the Sony A10. Took a little time to get used to, but it's a great little recorder.